Hey everyone, this is Game Informer's Test Chamber, and today we're taking a look at Tropical 5. I know it doesn't say 5 there, which is very strange on the title screen. I'm Andrew Reiner, and Dan Tack is here.
Hey.
Hello, sir. How you doing, man?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. You played this for a review.
That's right.
You've put in a lot of hours, and you're going to kind of walk us through single player, I believe.
Sure.
And there's also multiplayer. Tell me about that before
this
we get
is
into
the,
it.
This is actually the first Tropico game that has multiplayer, so it's actually really cool. But at the same time, it's sort of playing together alone kind of thing.
How does that work?
So you're all sort of... It's essentially the same single-player game, but you're all on the same map. So at times you'll be competing for resource points, or you're going to watch your friend get blown away by a disaster, but it's not as inherently competitive as, say, you know, StarCraft or another game where you're really in there gunning for your opponents.
Are you all individual dictators then?
And yes.
You have your, okay.
All on the same land.
Gotcha. That sounds kind of cool.
So you've got other game modes to choose from, too. We're going to not bother with the campaign or the tutorial now, but we're going to just go into a sandbox mission.
I played Tropico 3. I didn't play 4. What are some of the new things over
the last one, I guess? They've done some revamps to some of the systems. So trading has some more stuff. Research has some more stuff. But, I mean, if you've played Tropico, you'll be able to jump right into this. And if you haven't, I would also say that it's one of the more accessible titles in the series.
Okay.
So we're creating our El Presidente here. Yeah. I don't want to spend a lot of time with it. But there's plenty of...
give her a biker helmet.
All right. Let's see what we got here. A biker helmet. All right. You could outfit your dictator a little bit, but...
Are there new unlocks with that, or is that kind of it?
I haven't seen any.
You'll still see her in the world, right?
Yep, she will be walking around your plot of land. So let's try to... let's get things spicy. Hopefully we see one in our time. Sounds good. This is basically standard settings.
What is that? Dance party?
Yeah, you gotta keep your people happy.
No, you don't.
Well, you don't, but you'll lose.
No, you won't.
Yeah, you will. Okay, so... we're playing a sandbox, so it's sort of freeform, but you'll get these tasks popping up all the time that you can basically make decisions. We're gonna just get the basic trading package here. So we're gonna be creating goods to export at our docks there. We're gonna make more than one.
What are you gonna start with?
Well, because of this, we're gonna start with a logging camp, and I normally wouldn't build a logging camp.
Tobacco.
But as you can see here, it sort of incentivizes you to what to build through tasks, which is great for a beginning player. It's like, just go build this. Okay. Then it'll be like, okay, go build that. And it gives you rewards for doing such. So we're lucky we started off near some trees, so that'll fit in right there. And
yeah, nice.
They'll tear down that stuff.
All right.
So it started us off with a plantation, too, which is great. Probably want to get another one going right away.
You don't usually start with a plantation?
It depends on the map, but... Generally, you want to get plantations and ranches started right away as they're your primary resource acquisition for exports in the early era. And the game actually is 3 eras now, so we're in the beginning of the colonial age, and we go all the way up to modern age.
And walk us through your review a little bit. What? Obviously, you said it's more Tropico.
Sure.
What does that entail?
It's actually a really... I had a lot of fun playing it. It's a really great simulation game for city builders. The only issue I have is that, you know, for all of its game modes and all of its and all of the different options and tasks that you encounter, it really feels, even as you move from game mode to game mode and scenario to scenario, that you're playing the same game. You get a lot of choices like this, but that was my main criticism, is that it does feel very repetitive for a sim game, and that's one of the strong points I think you need to bring out in a sim game, is that you continue to have variety as you go.
And this is only available on Mac on PC right now. It's PC. Coming to Mac, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, or
Xbox 360.
360. Yeah, not Xbox
and
One.
Mac, yes, not Xbox. Yeah, exactly.
Really strange.
Kind of confusing.
Yeah, but that's coming this summer then.
Yes, there's different. It's a staggered release date for all that stuff after the PC launch.
And I played 3 on 360, and it was pretty good. So
okay.
hopefully those ports turn out fairly well.
Like I said, no real, like, if you're into simulation games, this is definitely something you're going to play. It succeeds in a lot of areas. But it didn't really, even with the multiplayer coming in, which I was really excited about, again, it feels like you're playing a single player game. Your friends are in it, but you're still playing a single player game.
And what is kind of the end game of the multiplayer? Like, is it just knock the other guy out?
Well, that's the thing. Like, in the multiplayer games that I tried out, most of the people that lost, they lost because of, they ran out of mandate time. So they never even really had interactions with the other players. So, you know, you have this like sort of clock that's always ticking down.
Right.
And you have to do the task to keep it going up. And so if your friends aren't like, you know, on their game, or a disaster happens at the wrong time, then, you know, they just lose and you sort of forget that they were even there. So if you're going to play a multiplayer, I'd recommend it with a full game of four. Progress is the path to autonomy, Governor. Since you'll probably lose a few people just from natural course.
Right.
So you have this generalized sort of way you're always going to tech up. So, like, if you're in the Colonial, you're always going to have to build a library.
Giving them a library before they get food?
We've got
a grocery store, dude.
Oh, we don't have enough residences for a grocery store yet. They don't need to eat yet. El Presidente determines when they eat.
Where is she?
She should be walking around down there
somewhere. I saw her earlier.
Yeah, she's...
There she is. She's in the front of your...
Where?
She's around the corner there.
You can totally spin the
camera. You can't spin the camera?
You can.
I like the look of your island, by the way. I wanted you to kind of pan around.
Oh,
that
sure.
Big mountain there is cool.
Yeah, and see, this is all fog of war area, so we have to send exploration crews to discover this stuff. That's usually how you just get to the mines and stuff like that, which is sort of the next
volcano.
Tier of exploration. Yeah.
Disaster.
I should have put it on super high disaster so we would have had one.
I saw it when you were playing earlier. You had a tornado ripping
yes.
through. That was in the multiplayer game.
That was very unfortunate. Yeah, that wasn't a multiplayer match, yeah. That sort of knocked me right out of that multiplayer match. So, again, I really appreciate what they're doing there, and I really think that multiplayer has a great opportunity here. But maybe in Tropico 6, they'll...
Or is it something they could patch?
Sure, absolutely. No doubt. Just maybe change, tinker around with how multiplayer works.
What are you doing in the field? Go take a look. What's she doing? She's like,
I haven't assigned her anything. She's just hanging out.
She's way too old to be moving that fast.
I'll put her in this building, so...
Dan Tech, you lost her.
I did.
No, there she is!
That's okay. She's got stuff to do at the palace, okay? So, you know, we're going to want to increase her... I've just been wandering around here. This has been embarrassing, but...
You're just not very good at this.
Oh, I'm quite good at this. what I want to do is get another dock going.
Yeah. And then tobacco.
Yes, tobacco is always a good option. And you have various upgrades and stuff we'll take a look at right after this. Sort of ignoring.
Ah, you put them next to each other. I never put them next to each other.
Yeah, just for efficiency.
I never really thought about that. I always put them kind of close to whatever they're transporting.
Oh, that's a pretty good idea. I'm not having any luck with these roads right
now. Yeah, and tack.
Why is it not connecting? Wow, what is going on here?
I think you have to update your review, Dan Tag.
I think so, too. I can't click a mouse, apparently. What is going on here?
I'll just write that in the review.
All right.
Do the edit, the Reiner edit. That looks lovely,
I don't know why it's not connecting.
Maybe it has to be built first?
No, it doesn't. I know it doesn't. So this is just...
There.
It just doesn't want to do it. No, it's red.
Was the dock red too?
No.
It's building.
This is just I don't know what to do with that road was. We're gonna forget that ever happened.
I don't think anyone's ever gonna forget that. Maybe you're pulling it. There you go.
Yeah, we just had to do this. That's weird.
That was
okay,
weird.
Anyway. So as you develop and you learn tech, here's how the research works. You'll be able to get different upgrades. So this is a corn plantation, so it has the specific upgrade you can grab. But the thing is, you mostly always want to take these. There's not a whole lot of decision making in this.
Huh.
Your other buildings also have different... Must be
every drop against See?
Fighting. Yeah.
Get a grocery store.
But I'd rather
tack.
Do it after I get the incentive to do so, right? So I'm going to get a bonus for doing it when they tell me to.
Starving your people just for a bonus?
So
you sound like a good dictator.
In this way, you sort of game the system by sort of like, hey, I think I'm going to get asked to build this soon, so I'll just wait. And I guess I might as well build some houses too.
Yeah, there you go.
So you
love your people.
Here's the research. So it's pretty much
cowboys.
tiered. Yeah, and that'll give us the ranch upgrades. I like to get mines first because you can make a lot of money off of them. So that's what we're doing. As you can see, we've got our game speed turned up
to the max.
Faster. Yep.
Yeah, where are the ratings now? I see you got 21%.
Yeah, I'm not doing great, but it is early on. That's actually decent for this point in the game. We have to get to, I think, 50% or more to declare independence.
President, as you know, it is your will.
Arm wrestling, do that!
All right, let's do it.
The air was born. All animals.
I saw the speed you had. I bet you're really strong, too.
So we can pick a new person of the dynasty.
Inventor.
Inventor. Increases research. Yeah.
That is what we write in the history books.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, right? Yeah, right. He looks awesome.
He's ready to go.
Cowboy hat.
Cowboy hat. Do we have that option?
I just saw something. Whoa!
Let's go with that one.
Yep, Colonial. I like this.
Oh, wow, really? Okay.
For some reason, I was just reminded of that Peter Molyneux game, The Line Had in the Movies or at the Movies or whatever that was. Did you ever play that?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Ah, it was a game where you made, like, movies. I'm not dreaming that, am I, Jason?
I don't remember that one.
Not at all. I love that game, actually.
Dan Tech, you got to play that. We should do that for replay for all Dan right. Tech. Just for Dan Tech.
I'm going to have to now.
At the Movies, Super Replay. Let's do it.
Super Replay. Wow. 500 episodes.
Let's do it.
So here's the new sort of trading system once you set up trade lines with smugglers or other, or the West India Company.
Okay.
So this will tie ships up. So if you want to do it, but it's definitely something to consider if you see like the price of so if cotton's doing pretty good right now. I could if I wanted to dedicate some plantation to cotton and then ship it out. So it's a little bit more than just make
the
stuff.
Revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Oh, smugglers!
I don't think I want that.
Come on,
man! Why aren't people operating? I gotta build more.
Not very good, Dan Tech. Up to 30%, though.
Yeah, people are starting to like me.
But do you want that? Do you want to be a good dictator?
At this point, yeah. You pretty much have to. It's a balancing act. So right now we're exporting logs. It's going to take a while.
Okay. Yeah, plantation.
Do we need another one? I don't think we need another one.
You need as many as you can get.
All right, tobacco, right?
Yep. Tobacco and cocoa.
Oh, yeah, you're going for the classics.
Classics.
All right, so it's not letting us build anymore since we're so low on money. This will happen.
Since you're in debt, $10,000.
Yeah. It's okay.
That's pathetic, Dan Tack.
No, this isn't bad. We have a pretty decent setup here. It's not the best, but it's not bad.
And now this is like your typical sim game. You just kind of sit back and wait for it to develop.
And it does let you speed things along. We are on the max speed, so. But I guess it's a little bit more interactive than your standard sim game by providing you with these sort of incentivized tasks.
I don't remember with Tropical, could you have multiple islands going at once, or is it always just your one?
I think it's just the one.
One, okay.
I was
16 citizens.
I was hoping with frequent disasters, something horrible was going to happen in this, but we haven't seen anything yet.
No, it's nice and sunny, and everyone's doing well.
Yeah. So this is just the first age, and again, things change as you go along, but your basic goals remain the same. Let's get them a bar.
Maybe they'll do what Civilization's doing with the next one and go to space.
Oh, that would be interesting. Tropico in space.
Yeah, bring the tobacco fields up on a big spaceship.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
It would be awesome. All right, Dan Tack. You're not going to be out of money or in the black by the time we end this. You're in the red.
Well, that's because, you got to spend money to make money.
Yeah, I guess most governments are in debt. Right?
In this game, you really do. It's okay to go in debt early on. Just the important thing to do is to watch your mandate time and make sure you keep that going.
And it's out now for PC. What did you end up giving it?
I actually gave it an 8.5.
Nice.
Yeah, it's really solid. I don't think it has a lot of staying power. It's really fun while you're playing, though.
kind of like the Sim Cities have staying power, but this one,
yeah,
well, not the last Sim City,
right? Obviously, it really depends what we're talking about here.
Yeah, let's distance ourselves from that comment a little bit. Okay, thanks for watching, everyone.
Yeah.
And read Dan Tack's review; it's on the site. We'll see you next time on Test Chamber.